Warren Fiscal Court, Wednesday, March 25th, 2020, is now called to order. I want to welcome all of you all here. You all spaced apart more than 6 feet. Everyone is practicing social distancing here in the courthouse. I'd like to ask Esquire Doug Gorman to lead us in the pledge and lead us in invocation and immediately after the prayer, to lead us in the pledge.
Pray with me, Father. Thank you so much for this day, the day that you've made, a day that has fear and some anxiety, but things that we know that following the proper procedures, Lord, that we can overcome this. And I would ask, Lord, that anyone that hears this and can see this understands that you're in control of all things, and we should be feeding our faith and starving our fear. I ask your grace and mercy upon this great country, the leadership, this great county, and our leadership. I ask a special blessing upon our judge executive for the hard work he's been doing, and our emergency management team, for all of our department heads that have risen to the occasion, Lord, and have done things which I know would be pleasing to you. But I also ask, Lord, for your grace and mercy upon our entire world as this virus continues to wreak havoc. But Lord, with faith in you and with the proper procedures, we know, Lord, that this too will pass. And we just ask you to continue to bless our community, bless our leaders, and bless this meeting this morning. I ask all these things in your precious Son, Jesus' name. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, and indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings.
Here.
Esquire McWhorter.
Here.
Esquire Lawrence.
Here.
Esquire Gorman.
Here.
Esquire Payne.
Here.
Esquire Young.
Here.
All right. Everyone is here today on Fiscal Court. No one else is in the audience here, but we're broadcasting on Channel 195 to you in your home. We have a lot going on, and we have an agenda here, and we have to take care of the people's business. But this may be our last gathering of Fiscal Court altogether, as we're wiring the courtroom for the probability that one or two, or maybe all of us, are going to be in quarantine by the next meeting. So we have to assume the worst, plan for the worst, and hope for the best. But we will be, any meeting that we have will be broadcast, and people at home can hear everything that goes on. We're encouraging anyone who can stay at home. If you can't, like many of us, you have to get out. Be sure to practice social distancing. Social distancing doesn't mean that you can't communicate with your family and friends. It just means keep a respectable distance. Stay at least 6 feet apart. If you can stay away from people and utilize technology and use FaceTime and text, emails, Skype, those sorts of things, you may end up seeing your children and grandchildren more often than you ordinarily do, just through technology. You may, like many of us over the last several weeks, have met together and have talked together and met with people all over the country and all over the world, but we're doing it through technology and through the telephone. And it's important to know that this is the difference between slowing this virus down and continuing to go on with our lives after this is over. I'm not going to go through the history of how all this came about, but it started on the other side of the world, literally on the other side of the world. And in a few short months, it reached our shores, in a few short weeks. Many of us were minimally concerned at first. A lot of people felt that this was blown out of shape. It was political in nature, or a number of other theories that and rumors that just popped up. Let me assure you, everyone at home, that this is real. This is here now. And it's been in Kentucky for only 3 weeks. Well, actually 2.5 weeks. The first case was confirmed in Kentucky on March the 6th. It's here now. We have, as of last night, and I'm sure it's changed by now, as of last night, there were 6 confirmed cases in Warren County. 10 confirmed cases just in the South Central Kentucky or Brad area, our 10 counties. Be aware, be prepared, that you should not be surprised that tomorrow will bring more cases and the next day will bring more right here in our community. People you know, people you love will be affected. Government can only do so much. Government at every level, in every department, locally, state, and federal, are working to contain this. But only we, individually, can do something about it, slowing it down. We've got healthcare people that are working diligently to make sure that they're prepared here in Warren County, prepared in Kentucky. But they need your help. If you will stay at home, if you can stay at home, stay at home. Don't go out and mingle. Don't have a lot of friends over. Practice social distancing. I know that's the buzzword today, but it is an important buzzword. You've got to stay away from others. The primary thing that all of us should do is make the assumption that everybody else has this virus and you don't want to get it yourself and you don't want your children to get it. And at the same time, assume you have the virus and you don't want to give it to anyone else. So practice social distancing at home as well. I can't stress enough how important it is to be mindful of this all the time. It's not something you need to be panic about, be scared of, but be respectful of this because it is something that can kill people. It's totally indiscriminate. The rich, the poor, the every race. And until recently, we thought only the older people could get it. We recently had, not in Bowling Green or Kentucky, but we recently had someone die that was a young child, a couple of young children. It can happen, and it could happen to us. We've got to understand the importance of our own actions and the actions of our children. You need to talk to your children. Make sure that your children are aware of how important this is. Make sure they understand it's serious. Try not to scare them, but this is not something that anyone needs to take lightly. We individually need to be responsible. Those people who take irresponsible actions and go out in public, travel to other areas, you're going to bring it back to your community. It may not affect you. It may not affect you too adversely, health-wise. But I can promise you it will affect people that you know and people that you love. So I'm asking everyone to please be responsible for yourselves and your families and the people you work with. I'm asking you to go ahead and make that commitment today. Many people are getting sick now that were exposed maybe a week ago, maybe 2 weeks ago. I think our community as a whole, most of the individuals are trying to do the right thing. And I hope that they will continue to do that and continue to encourage all of their family and friends to do the right thing. Those people who are irresponsible in their actions will affect our entire community. And if we don't slow this down nationally, statewide, and particularly here local, we will overwhelm the healthcare capabilities. We're already testing their ability to acquire supplies and personal protection equipment. We're working on that every day. Every day, I meet with, on the phone, a number of people throughout the community in healthcare, government, around the state. We have conference calls with Kentucky Emergency Management. I meet every day, multiple times a day, with our local emergency management, our local health department, our Kentucky Health Department. We've met with our senators and our congressmen, asked them for assistance in acquiring testing. Over the years, I have declared an emergency in Warren County a number of times. Within a couple of weeks after I was first elected, we had a blizzard, ice storm, homes blowing up from the freeze. We declared an emergency. I had the National Guard reporting to me. Little did I know at the time, since I was just elected for the first time, that the county judge executive is in charge of emergency management, and the emergency management locally reports to the county judge. And within days after declaring the emergency, and it was a serious emergency, I had the National Guard reporting to me. The governor sent them in to report to this brand new county judge executive. I thought this was the biggest event that I would ever see in my life. And we took it seriously, and we got through it. In a week, everything seemed to be back to normal. Most things were covered by insurance. There was a lot of hardship, a lot of damage, but it was a relatively brief period of time compared to this. Later, we had the hailstorm and tornado in 98. We've had a number of serious events. We've trained and prepared and had tabletop collaborations with all of our local partners and state partners to prepare for any eventual problem. Pandemics, we've trained for that. We weren't well prepared for this particular outbreak. We also prepared for terrorism and a number of other man-made possibilities. We felt we were on top of it. And I felt our community was as or more prepared than most communities. And I think we are in this case too, as prepared or more prepared than most communities. But every single community in the United States and maybe around the world is affected by the coronavirus. Many of us may have been exposed, but we don't know it yet. We've worked on testing. And testing is, this is the most unusual situation that I've ever seen. Testing is available. We worked for a number of days on trying to get testing that we could test everyone regardless of symptoms, only to find out that most of the tests are come back false negatives unless the person is symptomatic. If you're not having symptoms, you go get a test. You may get the test, and it may say that you're negative, and you're going to go off with a self sense of freedom, and you're going to continue to interact with people, socialize with people, and then you're going to find out 2 days later that you have symptoms. So those people who are rushing out and trying to get tests in different states or in different offices, just know that at this point in time, and as of yesterday when we talked to Dr. Shadowin about this, the tests are unreliable unless you're already symptomatic. The tests that we're aware of. Now maybe I saw on the news this morning they're coming out with some new tests. That's good. I hope they work. But as far as the reliable sanctioned test by the CDC at this moment in time is the testing that we're doing here in Warren County and across Kentucky and in most communities across the nation are more reliable if you're already symptomatic. And there are a lot of people who are symptomatic, who have symptoms, who are getting tested and they find they have the flu or they have another virus, but it's not the coronavirus. So they don't have to be treated the same, but it's a good practice to go ahead and quarantine anyway if you've got a disease or a virus that can be spread. But we have simple things that people can do at home. Wash your hands. I have to read hundreds of pages every day. My worst habit that I haven't been able to kick is I lick my finger to turn a page. I'm now invested in some Quicksort, trying to kick that habit. I have quit shaking hands. I have quit giving people hugs. Those are the things you miss. But we all have these little habits that we need to break to keep from getting the virus and to keep from spreading it to people you care about, to anyone. But if you'll wash your hands, and everyone's heard this, so I'm not going to repeat every single step, and we put it online, we put it on social media a number of times, and we will put it on our public channel here after today's meeting again. Wash your hands. If you have contact with someone or anything that someone else touches, wash your hands again. Never touch your face, your mouth, nose, ears, eyes, after you've touched something that someone else touches until you wash your hands again. You touch something, the virus doesn't go through your fingers, but it travels through your hands and other objects when you touch your face. It comes through your mouth, nose, eyes. That's how those types of secretions get into your system. So be conscious of that. Those things are important. Here, as soon as the first case hit Kentucky, we started cleaning the courthouse, cleaning the parks. I'm not talking about just cleaning them. We clean them every day anyway. But we've started disinfecting and sanitizing everything that people touch. Whether it's a microphone or a telephone or doorknobs, the handle on your toilet or the faucets in your bathroom. Those things that other people touch, we need to keep them disinfected, sanitized, so that we can keep from spreading it, keep from getting it. Those are important things. Don't be traveling outside of your immediate area. Don't be going to other states. Certainly don't travel internationally right now. That doesn't make you popular at home. Your kids want to go somewhere for spring break. My grandkids were devastated when they had to cancel out their spring break travel. And I think they're still angry with me. But they're safer not doing that. You're safer for them not doing that. And we all need to explain to our children that they're not invincible and that we're not invincible and that we need to be responsible for each other. We're all dependent on each other to get through this without overwhelming our healthcare system. Because we may have people, we have one of the best healthcare communities in the state of Kentucky or anywhere in the country. Many places, many counties, in fact, don't have a doctor. Very few have the type of healthcare system that we have here, with hundreds of doctors and literally two of the best hospitals in this area of the country. We have specialists. We have specialists in this type of communicable disease, this type of virus. I'm not sure anyone's a total specialist in this virus because it's a whole new thing. But we have to be conscious of where we are at all times. We have to be conscious of our actions. We can't be licking our fingers to turn a page. If someone else is going to handle that page, we're endangering their health. If someone else is going to use that faucet in the bathroom, we're endangering their health if we don't keep that clean. Most people understand this, but when you leave any public restroom, grab a paper towel, use the handle on the toilet or the handle, get a different one for the handle on the doorknob or the handle of the door. Don't touch it, don't contaminate it, and don't pick up the virus or germs from other people. We're going to be a lot more cautious of these things when we come out of this, but please look at our social media, the city's social media, and the state social media. I think we put on everything under the sun. The 1-800 number for the governor's office is 1-800-727-5725. And we'll put that on the screen here after a while, and we'll also put it on social media again. But if you have questions, the hotline in Frankfort is the place to go. If you have local questions about what to do here locally or in South Central Kentucky, how do you pick up certain types of services that are maybe something you don't ordinarily have to do before this, call 211. That's a local information system operated by the United Way, and that we're in contact with them multiple times a day. And it's terribly important. Ronnie Pearson, who heads up our local emergency management that I meet with and talk with multiple times a day, is also meeting with and talking with a number of the same people I talk to and a lot of other people with the National Guard, with the Kentucky Emergency Management, and others. But these people, there are a lot of people that are looking out after your and my collective health and well-being. But what is it, Smokey the Bear says, only you can prevent forest fires. Only you can prevent you from being exposed to this virus. We are the only ones who are in charge of our personal health and the health and welfare of our children. It's up to all of us individually to protect our families the best we can. We're all going to continue to work hard for the people of Warren County and the people of Kentucky. But we're asking everyone at home and everyone in the county to be conscious of what they're doing at any point in time. Don't be afraid to leave the house if you have to go to the grocery store, if you have to go to the pharmacy. There are people who will deliver pharmaceuticals and deliver groceries. You can do that. But even then, when the bags come in, other people have touched them. Take your groceries out of the bag, wash those protective, anything that you think someone else has touched, just wash it. Not a big deal to wash it before you put it in your refrigerator or on the shelf. A can, canned goods, wash the can, dry it, put it up. Protect your family the best you can. Be conscious of it. Don't be panicking. Don't be in fear. But do the right thing and we'll all get through this together. If we all continue to do the things that we know we should do, then we'll all come out of this unscathed. We won't overload the healthcare system here. And everyone will come out of this a whole lot smarter and a whole lot more conscious of where we are. Every other emergency I've dealt with has an end. This is going to have long-term effect on a lot of us. It's going to have a long-term effect on business. It's going to have a lot of long-term effect on the types of jobs that were available 3 weeks ago. But two things I want to say is don't be concerned. Well, be concerned, but don't be surprised that today will bring new confirmed cases to Warren County and Kentucky. Don't be surprised if by the end of the week we have a number of new cases, and the end of next week a number of new cases on top of that. But we believe that it should stabilize after that because of the actions and the sacrifices that the people of our community are making by staying home, away from other people. And I believe that that's the only way we're going to slow this down so that we can take care of the problem and keep from overwhelming our infrastructure and our system. And at that point, then we have to worry about digging out of the economic situation that we've found ourselves in. We have one of the strongest economies in the state in Warren County. Someone in the media asked me 6 months ago, what do you worry about happening? What's going to happen? You know, what do you worry about breaking up this role that we seem to be on? And I answered back then, I don't really think that, I think we're in good shape, and I think we're on a positive road, and I do think we are. But I told this person with the media back then, you know, the only thing that can disrupt our economy here now is something that happens somewhere else. Something that some war breaks out on the other side of the world, or someone does something to someone else that creates a crisis on the other side of the world, an oil crisis or whatever. I never for a minute thought it would be a virus that started on literally the other side of the world just a few months ago. But anyway, I'm going to stop with that. I'm going to, if you all have any specific questions before we get into the heart of the of our agenda, I'll be glad to ask them. I think I've talked with all of you individually, but if you have anything specific that you want me to talk about, or if you want to talk about something that I'm not aware of, now's the time to do it. But now, when we get to the end of the meeting, I have all the department heads on the phone. I'm going to ask for their reports. I'm hoping that they all have, I'm hoping that those who have reports, who have things that they'd like to talk about that I haven't already rambled about, that they will share them with the people at home and with all of you all. But I'm very proud of what Warren County government has done. And I want to thank all of you all for your all's involvement and for your constant concern for the people of our county. And I want to tell you, I couldn't be prouder of our department heads and our employees here. They have approached their jobs every single day with a sense of purpose. They understand what they're doing. This three or four times cleaning and disinfecting and sanitizing, they understand how important that is to the people they work with, and they understand how important it is to the people who they work for. So, for those of you who are on the phone, on the department heads, please tell all of your employees and all of their coworkers, thank you on behalf of Warren Fiscal Court, and by extension, on behalf of all the people of Warren County. Now, if you all don't have any specific questions, you can ask questions anytime you want to during this meeting. But we'll go on to the agenda. At this time, we need to approve the minutes of the Fiscal Court meeting of March 13th, 2020. I have a motion to approve. We have a motion by Squire Gorman, second by Squire Lawrence. Any questions, additions, or corrections? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Lawrence.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next item is to approve the work schedule for the Warren County Road Department.
So moved.
Motion by Squire Payne, second by Squire Gorman. Discussion or questions? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Lawrence.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young.
Yes, ma'am.
Next item is to approve personnel changes for Warren County. Motion by Squire McWhorter. Second by Squire Cummings. Discussion. Questions? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Lawrence.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, the next item is to approve Resolution 2011, a resolution of the County of Warren, Kentucky, authorizing and approving the issuance of Warren County, Kentucky taxable industrial building revenue bonds in the aggregate principal amount not to exceed $175 million, the proceeds of which shall be used to finance the acquisition, construction, and equipping of an industrial building as defined in KRS 103-200-1A and leased to Crown Cork and Seal, USA, its affiliates, successors, or assigns, authorizing and approving a lease agreement, a payment in lieu of taxes, agreement, mortgage, if required, and such other documents, certificates, agreements, and/or actions necessary to or required for the issuance of the bonds and financing of the project. This is a industrial revenue bond, and all of you all know this, but I'm just stating it for the record. The county is simply a conduit for this, and it does not impact our credit, and we're not responsible for the debt service on this.
Motion
by Squire Cummings, second by Squire Young. Discussion or questions? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Lawrence.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Item number 8 is to approve first reading of Ordinance 2015, suspending time requirements of KRS 100-211-2C1. And this is the first reading of the ordinance to, this is about Planning Commission,
yes,
right?
Yes, sir.
Because of their lack of being able to meet certain time requirements or their inability to meet these time requirements is based on their inability to possibly meet as regularly because of the coronavirus outbreak. That's what this is about. And this just gives them additional time so that they don't let these particular issues drop. Okay, we have a motion by Squire Young, second by Squire Gorman. Discussion or questions? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings.
Yes,
Esquire McWhorter.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Lawrence.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, item number 10 is to approve the payment of $2,225 to DC Elevator for a full load test, good for 5 years, and is required by the state elevator inspector on the Warren County Courthouse elevator. Motion by Squire Cummings, second by Squire Gorman. Discussion or questions? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings.
Yes,
Esquire McWhorter.
Yes,
Esquire Lawrence.
Yes,
Esquire Gorman.
Yes,
Esquire Payne.
Yes,
Esquire,
ma'am.
Young.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I inadvertently skipped number 9. This is to approve the updated Warren County Regional Jail's use of force policy and inmate handbook. If anyone has any questions, I believe Jailer Harmon is on the phone, but if you don't, I think you all understand this, but he may want to conclude the explanation for the public in when he gives his report at the end of the meeting.
So moved.
Okay. Pardon me?
So moved.
Okay, we have a motion by Squire McWhorter. Second by Squire Cummings. Discussion, questions? Let's call the roll.
Esquire Cummings.
Yes,
Esquire McWhorter.
Yes,
Esquire,
yes,
Lawrence. Esquire Gorman.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young.
Yes, ma'am.
Item number 11, grant authority for the Justice Center to hire a night custodian. This is replacing the one who's retiring on July 1st, 2020, and has been moved to day shift to sanitize the buildings regularly. Okay, we have a motion to approve. Squire McWhorter, second Squire Lawrence. Discussion, questions? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire,
yes,
Lawrence.
Ma'am.
Esquire Gorman.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young.
Yes, ma'am.
Next item is to approve the extension of Aramark Commissary contract through December 31st, 2020, and then for more additional years, if agreed by both parties, for the Warren County Regional Jail. Jailer Harmon, is there anything on there you think needs to be explained? Or?
Hey, Judge, can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Okay, this was part of the contract signed for January 1st of 2018.
Yes.
We put both the commissary and the kitchen service all on the same time period, so this just formalizes that. But there's been no changes. This is what the court passed at the end of 2017, taking effect for January 1, 18.
Okay. We have a motion by Squire Cummings, second by Squire Payne. Any additional questions or anything for Jailer Harmon? Thank you, Stephen. Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McCorver.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Lawrence.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, item number 13 is to approve second and final reading of Ordinance 2009, authorizing a lighting agreement between Warren Rural Electric Cooperative Corporation and The Heritage.
So moved.
Motion by Squire McWhorter. Second by Squire Gorman. Discussion or questions? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Lawrence.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman. Esquire Payne.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young.
Yes, ma'am.
Next item is to approve second and final reading of Ordinance 2010, authorizing a lighting agreement between Warren Rural Electric Cooperative Corporation and Hardcastle Farms. Motion by Squire Cummings, second by Squire Gorman. Discussion or questions? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Lawrence.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young.
Yes, ma'am.
The next item is to approve second and final reading of Ordinance 2011, rezoning property at 490 Farley Lane from agriculture to rural residential, containing approximately 2 acres and presently owned by Edmund Warren Kinzer Jr. Motion by Squire Cummings. Second, Squire Young. Discussion, questions? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter.
Yes.
Esquire Lawrence.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman. Esquire
yes,
Payne.
Yes,
Esquire
ma'am.
Young.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Item number 16, to approve second and final reading of Ordinance 2012, rezoning property at 4325 Old Scottsville Road from agriculture to rural residential, containing approximately 2 acres and presently owned by Robert and Mary Brown. Motion by Squire Payne, second by Squire Lawrence. Discussion or questions? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Lawrence.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Did we get item number 15?
We did.
Okay. God. Item number 17. Approved second and final reading of Ordinance 2013, rezoning property at 7007 Old Green Hill Road from agriculture to residential estate, containing approximately 5.17 acres and presently owned by Judson and Cheryl Hink.
Motion.
Motion by Squire Cummings, second by Squire Gorman. Discussion or questions? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Lawrence.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young.
Yes, ma'am.
Y'all can excuse me just 1 minute. I've got to go get another pen.
I don't want to use yours.
Speech.
Yeah. Sucked all the ink out of it.
because you've been busy, right?
That brings up another point. One of the things that you touch the most that you never think about someone else touching are little objects like your pen, pencils, and your cell phone, most importantly. If I shake Tom's hand and he goes and washes his hands like he should, so do I. But then he goes and grabs his cell phone that he's already grabbed between now and the time. So now he goes back and picks up his cell phone, and his hands are
dirty
again. So clean your cell phones, clean your pens, and all the things that you use throughout the day. Okay, now we'll get back to business. To approve second and final reading of ordinance 2014, rezoning property at 0 Gherkin Road from agriculture to residential estate containing approximately 5 acres and presently owned by Philip and Gloria Moore.
So moved.
Motion by Squire Gorman, second by Squire Payne. Discussion or questions? Call the roll.
Esquire Cummings.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Lawrence.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young.
Yes, ma'am.
Judge, will you remove the approve the sale of the Dodge truck? I think that's next on your agenda.
Yes.
Let's remove that from the agenda today, please. I need to review that.
Okay. Item number 19, we're going to continue that to allow the county attorney to review that before the next meeting. So you may hear it in the next meeting, even though we may not be here during the next meeting. We may be meeting virtually. Okay, next item is, if there are no objections to that, 19, I assume that everyone, all the department heads understand that we need to review that first. And there are no objections here in fiscal court. Okay. We need to approve. Item number 20 is to approve the 211 report for February 2020.
Motion.
Motion by Squire Lawrence and second by Squire Gorman. Any questions? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Lawrence.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young.
Yes, ma'am.
Again, I just want to say they're doing a phenomenal job. The calls have picked up greatly, but they're helping a lot of people.
It's going to be interesting to see what their March report looks like.
The item number 21 is on the agenda for March 13th. It was approved for Window World to replace the chapel windows at a cost of $3,232. The correct vendor should have been Capital Window and Door at a cost of $3,090 for the lowest and best bid for the chapel windows at Griffin Park. I need a motion to approve that and acknowledge that we're not following the earlier direction. So we have a motion to approve. Motion by Squire Lawrence, second by Squire Cummings. Discussion or questions? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Lawrence.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne.
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young.
Yes, ma'am.
Next item is to approve the purchase of 4 power sweepers from CPG in the amount of $7,720. This is a state price contract for the 4 regional Warren County parks.
So moved.
Motion by Squire Payne, second by Squire Cummings. Discussion or questions? I know all of you guys know this, and people who've watched this understand this, but I just so the people at home understand. When we say state price contract or federal price contract or something, what that means is that these have already been pre-bid by the state, and we're just taking the lowest bid that has been pre-bid. Okay, we have a motion and a second. Do we have any question, any additional questions or clarifications? There being none, please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Lawrence?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Item number 23 is to approve a termination in the amount of $17,548.75 to Carpet Place of Bowling Green for replacement of the flooring at Griffin Park. There were three quotes received, and this was the lowest and best quote.
So moved.
Motion by Squire McWhorter, second by Squire Cummings. Are you on there, Chris? Mr. Comer?
Yes, sir, Judge, I'm here.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure, if you wanted to go ahead and just give a brief explanation just for people at home.
Yes, sir. This is several months ago, we replaced the tile floor at the Fillmore Park Gymnasium due to the age of it. It was starting to deteriorate with the laminate. This was a quote to try to do the same for our administrative office at Basil Griffin Park. Okay. To replace all the tile flooring with the same laminate material that was used down at Fillmore Park Gymnasium. Mm-hmm. This is one of our improvement projects that's been on the radar in our 2 to 5 year plan, and we're going to try to knock that out during this time.
Okay. Well, it's a good time to do it while we have the gyms and parks closed. That's the appropriate time to do it. Anyone have any questions, Mr. Comer? Thank you, Chris. Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings?
Yes,
Esquire McWhorter?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Lawrence?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, we need to make part of the record the Executive Order 2005 Declaration of a Local State of Emergency dated March 16th, 2020, related to the COVID-19 virus. Motion by Squire Lawrence, second by Squire Gorman to approve, ratify the executive order with a declaration of a local state of emergency. Is there any other discussion? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings,
yes.
Esquire McWhorter,
yes.
Esquire Lawrence,
yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman,
yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne,
yes,
Esquire
ma'am.
Young.
Yes, ma'am.
Next item is to make part of the record the order number 2004, press release dated March 17th, related to the COVID-19 virus. Without objection, that's hereby ordered to be entered into the record. Next item is to approve the 2020-2021 budget for the Warren County Regional Jail. Anyone have any questions about Mr. Harmon's budget?
I'll just make sure, Greg, he's presented to you and online. I mean, is it something you reviewed yourself?
Yes, sir. As far as that was, me and J.R. Harmon.
If you're going to need to come to the microphone there, Mr. Treasurer. If you could get the county attorney to move away from you a little bit.
What I was saying, Esquire Cummings, me and J.R. Harmon, we did meet. We tweaked a few things, and I'm comfortable with where it is. We're currently looking at saving about $519,000 from the contribution from the general fund.
Well, under that motion.
And a lot of that's due to Jailer Harmon's negotiation on the new Fed contract.
Cool. Good job, Stephen.
Doing a great job, Stephen. We have a motion by Squire Gorman, motion by Squire Cummings, second by Squire Gorman. Discussion or questions? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter?
Yes.
Esquire Lawrence?
Yes,
Esquire Gorman?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne?
Yes,
Esquire
ma'am.
Young?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next item is to approve the extension of the 2019 net profit deadline from April 15th, 2020 to a due date of July 15th, 2020, and that obviously corresponds with the federal guidelines and their extensions, so that everyone, all their accountants and taxpayers can have the extra time. So we have a motion by Squire McWhorter, second by Squire Lawrence. Discussion or questions? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Lawrence?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young?
Yes, ma'am.
The next item is to approve the contract with Toshiba for copiers, printers at the cost of $891.92 a month for the Warren County Regional Jail. This is a 48-month contract at state price contract. Motion by Squire Cummings, second by Squire Gorman. Discussion or questions? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter?
Yes.
Esquire Lawrence?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, the item number 29 is to approve budget transfers for Warren County.
So moved.
Motion by Squire Lawrence.
Second.
Second by Squire Cummings. Discussion or questions? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter?
Yes.
Esquire Lawrence?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne? Esquire Young?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Next item is to approve interfund transfers for Warren County. Motion by Squire Young, second by Squire Gorman. Discussion or questions? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter?
Yes.
Esquire Lawrence?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young?
Yes, ma'am.
Next item is to approve the claims. Okay, will the treasurer please present the claims to the court?
General fund, $219,538. Road fund, $51,963. Jail fund, $154,698. Stormwater fund, $193,490. Grant fund, $24,116. And E911 fund, $13,578. Be happy to answer any questions.
Motion by Squire Young to pay claims is submitted. Second by Squire McWhorter. Discussion or questions? Please call the roll.
Esquire Cummings?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire McWhorter?
Yes.
Esquire Lawrence?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Gorman?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Payne?
Yes, ma'am.
Esquire Young?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And we're having a little bit of a problem with our phones, but I hope that the department heads are still on here. If they are, I know that Sheriff Hightower has had a lot going on. Sheriff, are you on there? Do you have a report today?
He told me he wasn't going to be on it.
Pardon me?
I met him downstairs. He wasn't going to be on the call today.
Oh, okay. He's unable to be on the call today, but I can promise you he's busy. Ms. Yates, do you have a report from the clerk's office? I know you all have been busy. Her office is open. Let me make sure I rephrase that. The Warren County Courthouse is closed. She has rotating employees, cutting down exposure to each other, and having part of her group work on one day and part of her group working on another. And she is personally very busy trying to take care of every need that people have and all the services that her department provides. They are not open to the public. The courthouse is not open to the public, but they are available on the phone or online for many of the services. They are still providing some in-person services that cannot be handled over the telephone or online, like marriage certificates and notaries and things like that, but they're handling them through the outside window. They have tents set up over those windows at the courthouse, but they're asking for people to call before they get out of the car because they don't want people standing out there with other people. So utilize the telephone before you come to the courthouse and call the clerk's office. We'll put all the numbers for all the Warren County departments online or on the TV screen and online. I think they're already on social media. So you'll be able to get a hold of the people that you need to get a hold of. Now, Jailer Harmon, do you have anything that you'd like to report today, sir? Are you still on there?
Yes, sir. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can now.
All right. I wanted to say I appreciate the court's support on the budget. We did work several months to get an increased amount on our Fed contract, which is where we make the majority of our money. We're getting closer to being self-sufficient. I know that makes Greg happy, and I need somebody to go ahead and check on him for all those nice things he said. I'm sure he's probably not feeling well. But I do appreciate Greg's hard work working with us on the budget. It's something that's important to us as we try to take care of our employees. And also want to give a quick shout out to all of the jail employees who are in the face of this corona pandemic as well, along with our healthcare providers here in the jail. And very proud of their efforts and all of the virtual court hearings and soon to be attorney virtual meetings that we're putting up so that the attorneys and inmates can meet about their cases. And it's been a strange increase in workload and things that we didn't think we'd ever have to do. I can tell you the staff that I have pulled together and are working very well. I don't have any that have missed for child care. We don't have anyone with symptoms currently. So we're cleaning every hour on the hour. The inmates are doing extra cleaning work, finding ways to incentivize them to keep everyone, I guess, not in fear, but aware of what's going on. We're staying in tune with what the court's putting out. So big shout out to my staff. We're working hard to do our part. So we appreciate the court's support.
Thank you, Jailer Harmon. I want to thank you and your staff for the phenomenal job you're all doing. You are like all government employees considered essential, but certainly law enforcement and corrections cannot pause. And y'all have done a great job of making the best out of a bad situation. Okay. Mr. Comer, I'm sure you've got a lot going on. You're still there, Chris?
Yes, sir. We're still here. Just a quick update from the park side. As you know, that's in conjunction with Bowling Green City Government, decided that in the best interest of public health, we did close all county parks facilities, and the city as well did the same for all their recreational facilities, both indoor and outdoor, this past Monday. Just to let everyone know, we'll be reassessing that on a weekly basis with you, emergency management, and our partners with the city reassessing how we're going to proceed forward week by week. We're strictly disinfecting all the parks' properties still. All of our staff crews are still coming to work. We're doing all normal park-related tasks. So when the parks do reopen, the public can rest assured parks will be well maintained, groomed, disinfected, and that when it is time to get back outside and play and get back to a somewhat new normal, that the facilities will be ready to go. We've also started a motivational phrase program. If people drive by Ethan White Park or Fillmore Park on their way to the grocery or pharmacy, we've created a little program to hopefully create some motivation or a little bit of happiness. We'll kind of go to and from. It's called Phrases of Hope, and so every day our administrative and management and employee team have submitted weekly motivational quotes that we're changing every day until we get back to whatever the new normal might be, to help encourage people and to help with maybe lifting them up emotionally and mentally during this trying time. So raise the total, but if you drive by Tumble Park or Ethan White, you'll see that on the kiosk outside the park. Also, just want to thank the public for being patient with us. As you know, a fiscal court knows, every decision that we make is made with the public interest at heart. And during the current times that we're going through, we were still having large groups, large numbers of people, in excess of plus people, gathering at various park locations throughout both the city and county, and hopefully encourage and to support local health efforts and to keep our outbreak at a minimum. Both the city partners and us decided that for hopefully a short amount of time, that these closures would help encourage people to practice social distancing and to practice and to be safe during these times and promote local health. So we appreciate everybody's patience, and we'll give a further report as we proceed through this.
Thank you so much, Chris. Y'all are doing an extraordinary job, and for those of you who don't realize it, the Parks Department, like all the county government workers, they are team players. They help other departments every day and have done a tremendous amount of work for other departments, just like the road department and every other department does. They work with a sense of purpose to make sure that they help the people of Warren County, and I couldn't be more proud of all you guys. And now, need to talk to our technology guy on wiring and getting the courthouse all fitted up for us this morning. The Public Works Director, Josh Moore, who also is a man of many talents. Are you there, Josh, or are you off busy somewhere? Okay, well, if anybody knows how to call in or how to ignore me altogether, it would be Josh. So Mr. Moore is doing an extraordinary job along with all of the people that he works with in Public Works. And I'm sorry he can't be with us, but I can assure you he's out doing something that's very important for the people of Warren County. Mr. Young, are you there? Road Supervisor Jerry Young? Okay. And now someone who's really, really busy right now, our Emergency Management Director, Ronnie Pearson. Are you with us today, Ronnie, or are you?
Yes, sir, Judge.
Oh, okay.
Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Judge, it has been busy. I just want to say thank you to all the county departments. Everybody has pitched in and did things that were unique to make things happen in Bowling Green, Warren County. It's been a long road, but we still got a way to travel. I want to thank Fiscal Court and yourself for supporting everything we're doing over here. Long nights, early mornings, phone calls, texts, meetings, conference calls, but we're getting there. But I want to say thanks to everybody and to everything you're doing, and keep up the good work.
Thank you, Mr. Pearson. I want to tell everyone, when we do have emergencies arise, the Emergency Management Director is fully engaged pretty close to 24 hours a day, and he has been really, really busy, and I've worried the hell out of him during this process, and he's responsible for coordinating all the government services in every department. And he's someone that we all depend on, and in this case, we all depend on for the health of ourselves and our families. But he can't do it without all of our help. Okay, Mr. Brandstetter, Bob Brandstetter, PVA, are you with us, Bob? Okay. I know Mr. Appling is not with us. I don't think he's back at work yet, but I would like If is anyone else from the office, contractors licensing department? Okay. Mr. Peterson?
I'm here, Judge.
Oh, okay. I was getting ready to read your report, but that, I think that's, I'd rather you do it.
Yes, sir. We, like other offices, we are closed to the public, but all staff is still working. We do have less than 10 people in the office at any time. Most are working remotely. And just want to give a couple of kudos and shouts out to everybody. First of all, I will vouch for Josh Moore because I just saw him a few minutes ago, but not in person. We had a development review meeting, and he and two of his staff were part of that. We're doing that through Zoom and other electronic means, as well as we had most all of our private utilities represented there, and even had comments from KYTC. So, you know, we are figuring out how to do things differently. And honestly, I think in some cases, after all this is over, maybe better and more efficiently, I think we'll figure out better ways to do things. So, you know, sometimes it's these little things. Have to give kudos to the county clerk's office as well for staying open. We're still able to record plats and kind of keep that into the development moving, everything down from two or three lots to big subdivisions. So that's a big thing, to be able to have that service still open. Trying to figure out how to get digital signatures on those plats has been interesting, but I think we're working our way through that. So, you know, everybody is still working. We're still moving things along the best we can. We do have, heard you mention a little bit earlier, a challenge having a public hearing. So rezonings are kind of on hold at the moment until we figure out how to be able to have a digital public hearing where people have to be sworn in and give testimony. But we are working on that as well. Ms. Hurt and myself did listen to a virtual public hearing from West Hollywood, California, of all places, last night to try to get some ideas, and we are working towards that. And just wanted to let you all know that both your staff and us are still working, and we all working as a team, and make sure everybody gets proper credit for that. That's all I have.
Thank you so much. Mr. Peterson, you all are doing a great job, and this presents a challenge for all of us, but I know it's a particular challenge when almost everything that you all do has deadlines required by statute, and for the benefit of the public, you don't want to let those drop, and I hope we've helped you a little bit with this ordinance this morning, but we'll address other needs as time goes on. Ms. Alexis, are you there with us this morning? Okay. Mr. Markram.
Thank you, Judge.
Yeah, you don't have anything that you want to? Okay.
No.
All right.
No, we're good, sir. Thank you very much.
Okay. Are any of the fire chiefs on that want to give reports this morning? Chief Hamilton? Chief Duckett? Neither one of y'all on here? Okay. Okay. Okay, and before we ask for the reports or comments from Fiscal Court members and those in the here, I want to ask for if there are any, usually ask at this point, if there's anyone in the audience or anyone in attendance that wants to ask any questions or make comments. I'm asking right now to anyone who wants to call in from home, we have a phone set up here where everyone can hear exactly what you ask or what you say. And if you want to call in, it's 270-715-0935. We'll try to take 3, 4, 5 calls. We can't stay on here all day long, but we do want to address your concerns. Again, If there's anything that we haven't answered already, and you want to ask a question or make a comment about something we could do better, 270-715-0935. And you'll be on the microphone if you call in. Okay. Well, we'll wait a couple of. We're going to go ahead. The line's still open, but we'll start. Squire Payne, do you have anything you'd like to add or ask or tell us?
I don't think I can add anything that you didn't cover. I'd just like to wish everyone a speedy recovery that's fighting this disease, and that the county's doing, all our department heads are doing their job, and making sure that we're getting the best service available to the public.
Thank you. Thank you, Squire Payne. Squire Lawrence?
Yeah, Judge, I'd like to thank you for the good job you've been doing, the rest of the magistrates. I know everybody's in communication all the time. I think you're doing a good job. We'll get through this, you know, if we all work together and we all try our hardest. Our community out there, I think, is working pretty hard, trying to stay home, trying to social distance, but you'll see some people that are acting a little, what I'd call, irresponsible. You know, I've seen some stuff on social media and whatnot. One thing I'd like to do is I'd like to thank Reverend John C. Lee and the Mount Zion Baptist Church. They're doing the Feed America program over at Lampkin Park right now. John Emma Barnett's a good friend of mine. She's over there kind of heading that up, too. They're doing this at some risk to themselves, you know, because you know, they got to be touching the food, and they've got to be together to sort it out. They got about enough food for 1,000 different families over there, and they're handing out today. So my thoughts and prayers are going out to them. I hope they just keep up the good work, and if there's anything I can do to help them out, I'll be glad to do it. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Squire Lawrence. Squire Gorman, you have anything else you'd like to share?
No, Judge, but one thing I'll just share is, one, you know, the distribution network is alive and well, and so what that really means for everyone is staying home, but really we should not be going out to the grocery stores for more than 1 week's supply at a time. There'll be plenty of that, and so if we can reduce that urge to get things for 3 and 4 months at a time, if we can just do 1 week at a time, but also just noticing that from different things as well, social distancing, there's no need for more than one member of the family to go to the grocery store as well. I'm just concerned about, we still see entire family units going to the store. I have, it's not in the best interest. If we can all continue to keep social distancing, we can knock this out, not overwhelm our health departments. And I would like to give a special recognition to the hospitals and healthcare facilities in our communities that are working overtime to make sure they've got this under control. But it is a something we'll all get through, and especially if we all can continue to follow that best advice from the healthcare officials. Thanks.
Thank you, Squire Gorman. Squire Cummings?
I want to add a couple things. You've already covered most of it, but I want to say a really special shout out to Ronnie Pearson. We're very lucky to have somebody with his expertise and his leadership and his emergency management planning we're doing. So all the citizens of Warren County should rest assured that we have the right man in that job, and he's doing exceptional work. Only things I could add on far as helping people out on a something to do is, we don't take for granted going up to gas pumps. That's where a lot of times the virus is spread, is through that. So if you're going to fill your car up with gas, either grab your napkin or something that you can grab a pump with, because you never know who's touched that before you got there, and or who will touch it after you go there. I think you said it very clearly earlier that act like you are the only one that doesn't have disease. You want to protect yourself, but also act like you are the one with the disease, and you want to protect other folks. So, but gas pumps are something that is, we jump out of our car and get our cars fill up with gas. We don't even think about that, but I would encourage folks to use caution there and to use something to handle those pumps to protect themselves.
Thank you, Squire Cummings. Squire Young?
Thank you, Judge. Judge, there's a lot of talk about helping people that's out of work. But one thing that we don't hear a lot of talk about is the mental aspect of what's going on. A lot of people are struggling with being out of work, what they're going to do. There are agencies out there to help anyone that's struggling. And you mentioned earlier, 211. If you're having problems, please contact these individuals that are out there to help in any situation you find yourself in, especially a mental or struggling with personal issues that this kind of thing can cause to be escalated. So help's out there, and don't be afraid to reach out, even to your churches. So
I think especially to your churches.
Especially.
If you feel depressed, overly concerned, down and out, emotionally stressed, which everyone does, turn to your minister. We all, from time to time, need to counsel with someone. We can't all run out to the psychologist or psychiatrist. But more importantly than that, call your minister. If you have a friend who you recognize as extraordinarily emotionally distraught during all this, maybe they have 6 kids at home that they're not used to having all day long. Maybe they're concerned about their finances, paying their mortgage, and that sort of thing. Call their minister. Call your minister. Have them call that individual. We all depend on each other. And certainly medical health is important. Financial health is important. Mental and emotional help is extraordinarily important because everyone is under an additional stressful time right now. And we'd really appreciate you can't go to church on Sunday, or you shouldn't be right now. You should go to church on Sunday, but you can call your minister. Your minister is really looking for opportunities to fulfill their mission in helping you. I'm glad you brought that up, Scar Young. That's an important part of this, is keeping everyone healthy in our community from all aspects. Squire McWhorter.
And I'll follow up on the churches. I guess everyone knows probably that there's a lot of churches on TV and social media, Facebook, whatever, so they can still get their church. And my thought is to pray. And thanks for all you're doing. I know it's stressful for you, but thank you, and everybody.
Thank you. Thank you. Ms. Milliken?
I know it's very hard also on the small businesses, and so many of them have closed, and so if you can take any steps to order food, take out, drive through, the local downtown businesses, I think they are selling gift cards online. They'll let you order online. They're on social media showing what they sell, trying to get you to order. They will deliver, I think. They will ship to you. So supporting our small businesses at this time is also a very big deal. So if we can do that as well. Our offices are open. Our doors are locked based on the governor's order, but we are handling all the telephone calls. We're handling all the court proceedings. And so if anyone needs us, they can call 270-782-2760. That's our office phone number. The child support office doors are locked as well, but we're still handling calls and still working on cases, trying to assist individuals with anything they need. And on a lighter note, I hope everyone stays safe, but on a lighter note, Ed Dyer's birthday is tomorrow, and he's a very special person to this court, so I wanted to wish him a happy birthday.
Ed Dyer worked for the county for a number of years in a couple of different capacities, but he was the superintendent at the road department for a number of years. He's a good friend of mine, and I'm not even going to guess at his birthday, which birthday this is, but he's retired now, and we wish Ed Dyer a happy birthday. He's one of my favorite people in the whole world.
Yeah.
While we're wishing birthdays, I want to wish on April 11th is Squire Lawrence's birthday.
Happy birthday.
And
39 years old, I'll tell you what it's going
to be. Anyway, we want to wish you a happy birthday, and anyone else who's having a birthday out there, we wish you a happy birthday and hope that you have a happy, healthy birthday. Mr. Burrow?
Thanks, Judge. I just want to thank everyone for all their hard work during this time.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Ms. Hale?
Thank you, sir.
That's it. You feeling good?
I feel good. Thank you.
Stay that way.
I'll do my best.
And Deputy Judge Executive Smith is in the other room on the telephone, so she can't speak right now, but I want to tell you how much I appreciate the people at home, because actually our community is doing a good job. I'm very proud of the response that we've had from people and the limited amount of criticism. Certainly you see it on all the topics and social media. People are going to complain, and I guess for that matter they need a place to complain. But we are going to have economic concerns when this is over. But when this is over, and for the future, we're going to continue to do well in Warren County. We're thankful for all of our healthcare industry here. We want to keep them. We don't want to overwork them. Also want to tell you how we have constant contact with federal agencies and state agencies. Certainly the presidential administration is doing extraordinarily well, and the governor's administration is doing a great job of keeping us informed. Small business, SBA is making loans to small businesses. If you want additional information about that, the Chamber of Commerce is really engaged in trying to help all small businesses through a better understanding of the Small Business Administration. Certainly the career services, which is what many people still refer to as the unemployment office, are very busy right now, but they want to help you, and we'll continue to work hard for everyone who is unemployed right now. But one of the things that was brought up about small businesses, there are small businesses throughout the community who are delivering or allowing for pickups. Try to use your small businesses. It's so easy to use your small businesses. It's just as easy as using Amazon. But while all these small business, local businesses who make a difference to your local economy are losing money each day, Amazon's hiring 100,000 people because everyone's sitting at home and ordering from Amazon instead of ordering from the local eateries and local businesses who deliver. They're delivering, putting it on your doorstep, same day, sometimes within 30, 45 minutes, whereas you're going to have to wait maybe a day or two from Amazon, but you can still order from local businesses who will help to support your local economy and help provide a better future to our community. Okay. Is there any other business to be brought? Yes, ma'am.
The next court meeting, you might want to advise.
Next court meeting is. Next court, Warren County Fiscal Court meeting will be Monday April 13th, 2020 at 9 a.m. Right here in this courtroom is where I'll be, Lord willing. But we will be wired for all of you all to stay home if that's the case at, on April 13th. We'll make sure that all of you are able to see me, see each other, and I'll be able to see you on a video teleconferencing. So I just wanted to make sure that you know that, because this may and likely is a last meeting that we'll all be in together in person for the next month, 2 months, I don't know. It depends on how quickly we get our arms around this this situation. Okay, anyone else have any business? As far as I know, no one has called in that citizen's number. So if there's no other business, I'd like a motion to adjourn from Squire Payne, and second from Squire Lawrence.